point in these championships was in 20th place. She's headed to Switzerland as a member of the World Championship team. You see, the names in yellow, they're on their way to the Worlds. The ones in white weren't quite old enough. Beth?
I know this was your comment afterwards.
I was so mad. I just can't believe I...
Our tropical storm Ignacio, and you'll notice quite a cloud canopy at the cirrus level. In other words, way up there. These are the high, thin clouds that continue to kind of bow and spread out here. Upper winds somewhat favorable here, but we did notice that the upper trough to the west of the system with the southerly flow coming up here, a lot of the convection for quite some time has been north and east of the actual low-level center, which is actually down here towards the south of that large cloud field that you see before you. As of 8 p.m., about 695 miles west of Cabo San Lucas, Mexico, sustained winds at 40 miles per hour and northwestbound at 13 miles per hour. One impact from this particular system, regardless of what happens from here on out, is that a large part of the mid and upper level moisture may actually head towards Southern California or the southwestern part of the United States. Farther south, now there's Hawaii. Oh, about 850 miles southeast of Hilo. We do have quite a bit of cloud cover there, but no development. Looking at Typhoon Winnie, very interesting signature with this particular satellite view. If we could, I'd like to go to the other source for you and show the colorized version. We have what appears to be two separate eyewalls here. Interestingly enough, the center one continues to increase in overall strength as it moves west-northwest at about 10 to 15 miles per hour. Expected to make landfall on the China coast probably in about another 12 hours. Getting wind reports here to the south of 60 to 70 miles.
We don't have
to the hour. Time for the Tropical Update, which is sponsored by Lowe's Home Improvement Warehouse. Okay, you know things have been quite active, mainly in the East Pacific, but we will still continue to watch, of course, the Atlantic Basin for you to see if anything is organizing as waves come off the West African coast, as this is a pretty large area that is favored for tropical development throughout the middle of August. A very good concentration of storms we've had over the last 100 years just east of the Windward Islands, and also the Western Caribbean is a favorite area for tropical development this time of year. Let's see if anything is going on right now as we check on the broad perspective, the entire Atlantic Basin here. And we don't have much going on. We don't see anything distinctly sticking out. The Gulf of Mexico is quiet. The Caribbean is pretty quiet. We have been watching this little wave now as it gets closer to the island. We've had a low pressure about 1,010 millibars associated with it. The pressures have been steadily going down. Will?
Okay, Vivian, tell you what, we'll check on the tropics right now. We'll take over for Vivian. She's having some microphone problems at the present time. Once again, we're following a couple of tropical waves across the Atlantic right now. Probably the one which is the most ominous at the present time is this one approaching the Windwards right now. We'll be watching this one for sure. Again, we are looking at an area of low pressure associated with it. Conditions aloft, not all that bad. We're still looking at high pressure trying to strengthen now and build across the western part of the Atlantic Ocean into the Caribbean, so we'll be following that one for sure. So again, we watch for that tropical wave. Here comes another weak one right here, beginning to roll its way on towards the west. And just coming off the coast of Africa, again, we are talking about the Cape Verde season, here comes another tropical wave. Again, seems to be dissipating a little bit. We'll see if it strengthens a little bit more as it begins to roll its way on towards the west. We're also going to talk about a brand new tropical storm, now downgraded to a tropical depression. This is Tropical Depression Ignacio, the 2 o'clock advisory, Pacific Daylight Time. The center of circulation, 24.3 north, 120.6 west, or about 680 miles to the west of Cabo San Lucas in Mexico. Its top sustained winds, 35 miles per hour, below tropical storm status at the present time, but moving north and really hauling at this point, northbound at 14 miles per hour. This will definitely have an impact on the southwestern part of the country's weather, especially for the mountains of Southern California within the next 24 hours. Take a look at the moisture now beginning to go with Tropical Depression Ignacio on towards the north. This is Baja California, the southern sections right now of California right in through here. And it looks like overall we're going to be looking at some moisture beginning to roll its way back into Southern California within the next 24-hour period. So there we go, looking at Ignacio beginning to pull its way on towards the north. And we're going to be looking at probably some moisture into Southern California and back into Arizona, which means the monsoonal moisture is going to be around for a couple of more days.
Tropical Depression Ignacio. It is centered at 25.1 north and 121.1 west. It's about 750 miles west-southwest of Cabo San Lucas, packing winds about 35 miles per hour. It's moving west-northwest at 14 miles per hour. Now, it's moving into cooler water, about 23 degrees centigrade, which takes it down to about 72, 73 degrees. And you want water temperatures 80 degrees or above Fahrenheit or 26 degrees centigrade for these things to continue to intensify or even stick around. So it looks like Ignacio is going to dissipate, but it's also going to advect or take moisture and move it over an area in the southwestern U.S. So in California, where we've had some forest fires, maybe we're going to get some clouds moving in there now, and by tomorrow afternoon, maybe see some showers in the mountains, and it's going to bring some more moisture into Arizona. And the reports out of the Arizona National Weather Service office indicating they are perceiving some moisture in train from Ignacio moving across.
There is a tropical depression Ignacio. The last advisory has been written on it. The main concern now is how much of this moisture injection gets into the atmosphere as you head into central and even southern California. That could certainly play a part in precipitation amounts. We'll be talking more about that with the forecast.